Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah and welcome to Living Muslim, the new show on the One Path Network. What a fantastic opportunity to kick off the show in the greatest month of the year, the month of Ramadan, the month that every single Muslim waits for all year round. And to get a feel as to what Ramadan means to people, because it means so much to so many people around the world, to get a feel exactly what Ramadan means to us, we had Stools go out on the streets today to see what Ramadan means to you. And this is what he came up with. Kick it off for us, Stools.
We're here in Bankstown Square or Bankstown Centro, or now it's called Bankstown Central. What are your thoughts about Ramadan?
It's an Islamic kind of like observation period where they fast during the day and that sort of thing.
Well, Ramadan, I don't know that much about it.
I do know he's not supposed to, you can't eat sunrise,
yep.
Sunset.
Have a fast during the day and then you feast at night.
Well, that's like when the Muslims fast, isn't it?
Correct.
Right, like for one whole month.
My daughter's converted to Muslim and she follows it quite religiously, so to speak.
Wow.
Yeah, so
how long has she been Muslim for?
16 years.
It's amazing how strong and willing that Muslims are, how they do it. Like, it's amazing how they do it. I don't know how, but it's just crazy how they can fast for so long.
What are things Muslims do during Ramadan, bro?
They pray to their Allah.
What's something that you do in Ramadan?
You sacrifice for the sake of Allah.
Fast, pray, read more Quran.
Nah, straight out. It's a month to get back on track, you know what I mean?
Going to the mosque a lot and hopefully go to Tarawih every day.
Inshallah, I've got a couple of bad habits I'm working on this Ramadan, and because it's the month that I personally feel closer to Allah Azza wa Jal.
I'm going to pray, make sure I get all my prayers in, because honestly, not everyone prays all the time.
I want to go, like usually I go to the mosque of course, but I don't go every single day. I'm going to try and go every single day this year, inshallah.
Inshallah.
It's a month of worship, it's a month of happiness, it's a month of, you know, there's nothing better than Ramadan, if only you can go through the whole year.
It's not every month that it's Ramadan, so we use this time for the advantage to get closer to Allah Azza wa Jal.
It's about praying and your love for Allah.
It teaches us patience. It teaches us patience and it teaches us how other people feel.
We are the Muslim and this is the only one month.
Holy month.
To be holy month and to be see how the people is hungry in this world and how they feel.
It's one of the holiest months of the year and it gets us to get more humble in this month.
We've been kicked out. We tried sneaking in a few minutes ago, but they're going to call the coppers. And I'm really confused, so we're going to try to go back on the other side, okay? So you hoplos.
Thank you very much for that, Stools. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Joining me in the studio here today, I have Hisham and Ziyad. Shabab, thank you very much for joining me. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Ramadan means so much to so many people, as we've already seen. But I wanted to ask you guys on a personal level, Hisham, what does Ramadan mean to you?
Look, thanks very much, Oblos. I think what it means is sharing, like the aspect of sharing, because there's two things. One is like the family experience that we have,
sharing the
iftar together. But then also the other thing I was thinking about was sharing with non-Muslims. You know, at work, you bring in your plate of batlawa and you take it around at work and everyone's joining in. They're asking, what's Ramadan? And
yeah.
So I think it's really about sharing the knowledge and sharing, you know, the food as well.
And it's a very good chance to actually give dawah.
Absolutely.
Also, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Ziyad, what does Ramadan mean to you?
Thanks for having us on the show, Hublus.
Wallah, my pleasure.
Yeah, for me, Ramadan is personally about reflection and, you know, taking the time out from your normal schedule to sit down and connect with the Quran, come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Hisham, what is the purpose of Ramadan? I mean, what's Ramadan all about? Because, like you guys, you know, shared with us, I know everyone has a personal... relationship with the month of Ramadan, like you said, whether it's connecting with family, whether it's being appreciative. You know, for myself personally, it's da'wah, right? I love it. You know, it's a fantastic time for da'wah. I really get to engage with Muslims. But I mean, what do you think the purpose of Ramadan is? What's the Islamic?
Yeah, look, absolutely, Abbas. I think it's about change. You know, like one thing I've always admired about everyone is that they try changing something in Ramadan. And
yeah.
You know, even some of the boys that might be not so much practicing, you know, they might have a girlfriend, they'll try stopping speaking to her just during that month. So it really shows that people are making effort, and Ramadan is that time to do that. I think people understand it.
Well, I mean, look, we do know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, more or less, he says that the month of Ramadan, or fasting rather, is so that we may attain taqwa.
Mm.
So many of us tend to hear this, and I'm sure we hear this in all of the khutbahs, you know, to attain taqwa is to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But really, what it also means is to become conscious. to become conscious of yourself, to become conscious of your actions. And it's funny that you say that, right? Because many times you tend to hear from da'is or mashayikh or whatever the case is, we tend to hear this phrase, Ramadan Muslim, right? And really it gets me going because I've fallen into that. You know, I used to refer to people before as Ramadan Muslims. But then, you know, over time, you start to think, but hang on, really in the month of Ramadan, everyone is a Ramadan Muslim. Even the person that's very practicing, the person that's not practicing altogether, we all tend to have this, you know, this Ramadan Muslim, you know, like when the month comes, everyone wants to do more, practice more, get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, change our sins. So, you know, subhanAllah, you find that we become conscious and we start to measure. And, you know, speaking about girlfriends, you know, for me, when I look back, you know, back in the days, oh, some of the funniest things, wallahi, some of the funniest things, you know. I used to have friends that, you know, he would have a girlfriend, right? So there's no problem with having the girlfriend. But then when the month of Ramadan would come, you know, he would call her or send her a text message that, hey, look, you know, tomorrow's going to be Ramadan. So let's hook up tonight, right? Or let's get together today, yeah? Because as of tomorrow, right, as of tomorrow, I can't be with you or that I can't talk to you, you know. So while, yes, we can have a laugh at that, but it does show you how unique Ramadan is.
I think it's amazing that everyone understands it.
Everyone. Like, it really does get to everyone. You know, I remember Hisham years ago when I wasn't sort of practicing as much. You know, when the month of Ramadan used to come, it used to freak me out.
Yeah.
Right? It used to freak me out. Why? Because you're always hearing how great it is and this is the chance and this is the opportunity. But I used to look at myself. I used to think, man, well, I'm not praying. I'm not fasting. You know, I'm doing so many wrongs in my life. And now here comes this great month that I had no intention of engaging whatsoever. So I used to feel that it used to create a further barrier. You know, it used to create this barrier between me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I remember, you know, 11, 12 years old, high school, first year of high school, going to the bubblers behind the canteen and taking a bit of a sip of water.
Oh, man.
You know, just to get a bit of water in. And that was what Ramadan was like. Oh, it's so hard to not eat. It's so hard not to drink. But once you start to understand it, it changes. So I think that's the issue there, that we don't have that understanding and we're not communicating that to our kids and to our youth. That's the problem, I think.
I agree. I had a similar experience. Went to the water anab tree. Had a bit of a, like, had a grape just before iftar.
You snuck one in.
Yeah, I snuck one in. I had to do it. I was a bit hungry back
then. You know, we used to, you know, as kids, we used to come up with fatwas, right? Because really deep down, we're all scholars in deen, right? So when we were young, you know, and it was a really hot day, right? And I was only fasting because everyone else is watching me. So I came up with a fatwa with everyone at school that if it's really, really hot, you're allowed to have one sip, right? You're allowed to have one sip, you know? You know, look, I find that, subhanAllah, that many people want to get closer, right? Many people want to get closer. So guys, what are some of the goals? You know, what are some of the realistic goals that people can do? Because I know, again, Ramadan, we tend to hype it up so much. But everywhere you go, man, everyone's talking about reading the whole Quran. And everyone's, you know, and everyone's talking about praying these long prayers. But really, realistically, you know, realistically, who does that?
Yeah.
Who does that? So Hisham, I wanted to ask, what are some of the goals that you aim at?
I think the first thing I always look at is like, what's the easiest for me to do that I'm not doing yet? So things like, you know, your dhikr in the morning, it's very hard to keep doing it consistently. You might do it every now and then, but to do it consistently. So that's something I always try targeting, because if you can do it for the month, what's to say you can't do it outside of the month, you know? And the other one is like the sunnah prayers. Something so basic, but to do it consistently, even, you know, during the middle of work when you're so busy or in the middle of school, it's a bit hard. So if I can do this, my perspective is that I'll be able to do it outside.
It becomes a lot easier. Ziad, what about yourself? What are some of your goals?
The way I see it is, if you, like in Ramadan, you're actually holding back on things that are halal. So outside of Ramadan, it will be even easier. Like, it's meant to train you to refrain from that which is haram. So really, it's about building that, you know, that self-discipline in Ramadan.
Yeah. Well, look, I think that's a good point, right? Because we need to know that Ramadan is not just about doing halal things, right? Mm-hmm. Because really, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is far greater than needing us to stay away from food and water, right? So really, Ramadan, of course, it's about doing great things, but it's also about leaving some of the bad things behind. Because just like he said, Ziyad, you know, that imagine in the month of Ramadan, if Allah made what is usually halal, which is food and water, is usually halal, but yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it haram for us in the day. So imagine what the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made haram already. Imagine doing that. Guys, before we sort of come to an end, I wanted to ask, what are some tips that we can share with people that are realistic? All right, realistic. What are What are some of the things that people can do, Hisham?
Just before we hit that, I just wanted to say mabruk on the studio.
Oh, thank you.
You know, before we finish off the show, it's worth a mabruk.
It was all me, man.
Did you do all
of it?
All,
it was all me. The graphics, the colours, the scheme, right? All me, all of it.
Very hipster, I have to say.
No, that's wallahi, awesome. In truth, I actually had nothing to do with it. There were so many people behind the scenes, last part. But guys, thank you so much.
I want to compliment your shoes. First time I see you wearing Nikes.
They're awesome shoes, man.
We're trying to hide the shoes, man.
Give him
a
flash.
It's actually, you know what? I think I might sort of give him a flash, right? Of course, we tried to get the matching colours. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. But yes, thank you so much for pointing out the shoes, Ziyad. I'll pay you for that one later. Hisham, coming back, what are some realistic things that we can do?
Look, one thing that always works for me, is you find and you've done this before Ramadan, but you can still do it in Ramadan, get yourself 30 short video clips of YouTube. And I'm not talking about MTV, right? I'm talking about Numan Ali Khan, Hamza Yusuf, whatever your flavor is.
Right.
Get it. 5-minute clips every morning. You start the morning like that, just an imam pumper.
Yes, yes.
Whenever you feel down, replay it. That is something very simple.
Just like a short reminder, something to sort of give you an uplift for the day.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, well, that's excellent. Ziyad?
For me, it's to realize that change is step by step. You're not going to become a big sheikh in Ramadan. It's about establishing what you want to achieve. It doesn't have to be something massive. It can be something small, but work towards it, if you know what I mean.
Well, Ziyad, I really, really like that. Guys, thank you so much for coming in. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. And on that, I sort of want to sort of close it with that. I like this idea. Let's keep it short, keep it simple, and let's be specific. You know, I always say to the people, wallahi, and inshallah, I'll share this, you know, for myself and for you guys, you know, to be specific with what you want, you know. The Prophet of Allah, he says something small but consistent is far greater in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than doing something that's large but a one-off, right? And something else that I also like that you sort of touched on too, Hisham, is, you know, one goal that I have is, you know, when you share the idea of doing something new, it becomes a burden. Oh, come on, man, I have to do something, right? But alhamdulillah, for most of us, we pray. And if you don't pray, well, then what a better chance than this month to start praying. But if you're someone who prays, well, you know, regardless throughout the day, I'm going to come to these 5 prayers, right? So if you want a realistic goal, add to them. Add to them, whether you're praying your sunan, right? We know that the Prophet of Allah says, whoever prays his 12 raka'at of sunnah in a day, for him, the Prophet of Allah says, I promise him a palace in paradise. So imagine every day in Ramadan. And these are things we can take further. So these are things we can take after Ramadan, right? So of course, joining things to the things that I'm already doing. I'm praying 5 times a day, we can attach things to them. Small, specific, it's not going to burden me, it's not going to be difficult. You know, praying our sunan prayer, making afkar, salat ala Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, charity a day, giving $1 a day. You know, giving $1 a day throughout the month of Ramadan, I think that's a great goal. Why? Because I know every single day in this blessed month, I tick the box of charity. And so specific, small, achievable, and wallahi, you will get there. You will get there. This is the greatest month. This is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I've opened the doors of my paradise and we've closed the doors of the hellfire. So this is the opportunity for every single person to come on. Once again, guys, thank you so much for closing. Thank you all very much for joining us. Please take advantage of this blessed month. Everyone is welcomed in the month of Ramadan. Absolutely no one has the right to turn anyone away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is far greater than any one of us. So please take advantage, dive into this opportunity, dive into this endless ocean of mercy. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward every single one of you. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.